Hi and Happy New Year! Welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. This year we are going to start off with going over some of the different applications found in Microsoft Office. In case you've never used Office before, this video is going to be an introduction to some of the main applications that are included in Microsoft Office. We are going to do a quick review over Microsoft Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Microsoft Teams, Outlook, OneDrive, Access, and Publisher. So let's start with Microsoft Word. If you have never heard of Microsoft Word before, Microsoft Word is what is known as a word processor. So what is a word processor? A word processor allows you to type up a document, and this could be any kind of document. If you're looking right here at the different templates that are available in Word, you can see that different documents include term papers, any kind of document you would write to someone, a formal letter, maybe a resume, even a book with a table of contents, a menu, a brochure, a calendar, etc. So if we just look at a few of these, you can see that you could create a resume within Microsoft Word, and you could edit the information right here, and you could make it look really nice and professional. And you could do the same thing for any kind of document, for any kind of paper. You could create a table of contents for a really long, in-depth report. Microsoft Word is a word processor. Next, we have Excel. Excel is what is known as a spreadsheet. So what Excel allows a user to do is enter data inside of a grid type of document like this, where numbers and other data can be entered in a matrix type form, and that data can be analyzed and grouped together, and charts can be made from the data, as well as anything that would look good in a grid type format, such as a calendar or an attendance report, or anything where you would want a bunch of little checkboxes to appear. But usually Excel is used for data analysis. So an example that we could look at right here would be an invoice where data could be entered across the top and other data could be summed up on the bottom right here. Most of the videos we've done for the past few years have been done in Excel, so you can check some of those out that already exist on our channel. Next up is PowerPoint. PowerPoint is a presentation software that allows you to create presentations for an audience. And you can integrate multimedia such as video and music and make an exciting presentation for your audience. So let's look at an existing PowerPoint presentation. If I go up to slideshow and I click from beginning, I can start watching a slideshow inside of PowerPoint. If I hit the down arrow key, I'll be able to scroll through each one of the slides, so you can see how this would be a helpful tool to have when you're doing a presentation. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel to get new weekly Microsoft Office tips. Next is Microsoft Teams. Microsoft Teams is a video conferencing software, and probably over 2020 and 2021, you have seen or heard of video conferencing software such as Zoom and Google Meet and Microsoft Teams. Microsoft Teams is Microsoft's version of video conferencing software where you can share screens on different people's computers. You can see the other person through the camera on the computer. You can talk through the meeting with someone else. And there's a lot of other functionality in Microsoft Teams that we will cover in that lesson. But for now, the main function of Microsoft Teams is to be able to conference with other people across the internet. Our next application within Microsoft Office is called Microsoft Outlook. Microsoft Outlook allows you to send emails to people and keep track of all your emails within an email management system. Microsoft Outlook also allows you to manage your personal calendar and your business calendar and to share your calendars with other users, as well as manage your contacts that you have inside of your system and share those contacts with others as well. Next up, we have Microsoft OneDrive. Microsoft OneDrive is Microsoft's version of the cloud. Files in Microsoft OneDrive allow you to share files across the internet with other people. It also allows you to open up the same file on different devices, whether it be your home computer or a laptop or a smartphone or a tablet. And it also allows you to open other files in other places. And that file just travels along with you wherever you go. Next up is Microsoft Access. Microsoft Access is a relational database management system, and Microsoft Access allows you to store data inside of what is known as a table and use that information in a table to relate to other tables within your database. A table in Access is similar to a spreadsheet that you would see in Excel, but Microsoft Access allows you to do a little bit more with your tables by relating them together. And Access goes a little bit further to allow you to create forms for users to go in and enter and edit data. And Microsoft Access also allows you to create reports that have the data that has been entered into any of the tables, whether it was through a form or directly through a table. Microsoft Access also allows you to query your data based on any kind of given criteria and get that data back out and analyze it in a way that is different from Microsoft Excel. And finally, we have Microsoft Publisher. Microsoft Publisher allows you to do a lot of graphics on creating event flyers and brochures and cards and anything else that would require a graphic interface. So for example, you can see that I can create a flyer for an event using a lot of different colors and attract attention to certain parts of my flyer. So those are just some of the main components of Microsoft Office. Again, we went over Microsoft Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Microsoft Teams, Outlook, OneDrive, Access, and Publisher. In the upcoming weeks, we will go into each one of these in a little more depth and give you some tips and tricks for how to use those. So hopefully you learned something new today and look forward to seeing you again for those videos.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.